I was listening to an episode of The Moth a few months ago and heard a story told by scientist Sylvia Earle. She told the story of Tektite II, an underwater habitat where she lived for 2 weeks in 1970. At the time, she was a botanist and passionate about seaweed. I was intrigued and was amazed at the work she had done in her life. Sylvia Earle was born in New Jersey in 1935. She got her bachelor's and her master's from the Florida State University and her PhD from Duke University. She went on to do more amazing things than I can list, but I encourage you to check out the sources in the description to learn more about Dr. Earle's amazing work. What I was most fascinated by was Dr. Earle's time spent studying seaweed on Tektite II as an aquanaut on an all-female team of scientists. She applied to the program while a research fellow at Harvard University when she saw an ad seeking participants for this experiment. Tektite II, the underwater habitat, was two 18-foot cylinders on the ocean floor, 50 feet below the surface of Great Lamasher Bay in the Virgin Islands. It is seen here before it was lowered into the water. Aquanauts entered and exited the habitat by scuba diving to a hatch at its base. Dr. Earle was part of a team of 5 women, 4 scientists, and an engineer. This was Sylvia Earle, Renate True, Anne Hartline, Aline Smart, and Margaret Lucas. They spent almost 2 weeks living underwater, performing research and going on dives outside of the habitat. 2 of the research projects performed by True, Hartline, and Smart involved studying fish behavior. Dr. Earle's project looked at the effects of pollution on coral reefs. In addition to being a research mission, the stays in Tektite II functioned as a psychological experiment. NASA, as it explored the potential of space travel, wished to see how the confinement and isolation of such a mission affected the aquanauts. And while there were a total of 11 missions in the Tektite II habitat, the inaugural all-female team received the most press. The team also ate test space food created by Skylab during their stay. In an interview, engineer Peggy Lucas described some of the dishes as pretty bad. The Tektite missions were a fascinating endeavor in science, both as an experiment living in tight quarters and for the oceanographic research that was performed on them. As I mentioned, Dr. Earle's time on Tektite II was by no means her only or coolest achievement. She is still doing amazing things today, including being president of Mission Blue, an organization dedicated to exploring and protecting the ocean. I've included a link to their website in the description. I often discuss terrestrial plants, those that live on land, but aquatic plants need our love and support too. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to support Brilliant Botany, you can head over to Patreon and become a monthly supporter. You can help Brilliant Botany grow and get awesome perks. You can check out the link to a playlist in the description of all of my videos about awesome women in science and botany. If you have any suggestions about scientists that I should cover, please leave those in the comments, and I will see you soon.